Hello dear students, in the previous class we started chapter 2 and in that series today we will discuss Congress dominance in the first three general elections. So let's start our class and discuss the context. The results of the first general elections did not surprise anyone. When the results of the first general election, which was held in 1951 and 1952, did not surprise anyone, because anyone knew very well that Congress was the most dominant party in that time and it got its inherited legacy from the national movement. And at that time Congress was the oldest party which was framed before independence in 1885. So it was obvious and clear for everyone that Congress will win the election. That's why when Congress won the election, nobody got surprised. And as the leader of Congress party, Jawaharlal Nehru became the first Prime Minister of India. And Nehru, as the leader of Congress, also made some visits to each and every part of the country for promoting his party Congress and party members. And when the results were declared, then Congress party won 364 seats out of 489 seats in the first Lok Sabha elections, which were held from October 1951, and they lasted for 6 months, and that's why they were also continued up to 1952, and that's why they are known as the first elections of 1952, as the major portion of these elections was held in 1952. And in the first election, the Communist Party of India, that came next to term of seats won 16 seats, okay. In the first election, the Communist Party of India, it also registered its victory on 6 seats. And here's a map which depicts the position of that time of Indian politics. Here we see that the portion, the areas of India which are depicted in yellow color were governed by Congress, and at these places Congress registered victory. And the red one, they depict Kerala, and here domestic left front won election in 1957. And in Jammu and Kashmir, there was one more party, that was National Congress. National Congress framed its government in Jammu and Kashmir. So dear students, as this map depicts, shows that from the first election till the third election, from 52 to 62, there was only one dominating party, that was the Indian National Congress. And in all these three elections, Indian National Congress won almost 3/4 part of टोटल सीट्स। इन फर्स्ट इलेक्शन कांग्रेस वन 364 सीट्स आउट ऑफ 489। इन सेकेंड इलेक्शन कांग्रेस वन 371 सीट्स आउट ऑफ 494। इन थर्ड इलेक्शंस हेल्ड इन 1962 कांग्रेस वन 361 सीट्स आउट ऑफ 494 सीट्स। सो by these results we can say that during that time from 1952 to 1962 there was only one dominating party, that was Indian National Congress. But as the graph, as the map shows us that in the election of 1957 Congress was defeated in the region of Kerala. In Kerala, CPI, Communist Party of India, made its government and registered victory in Kerala. So it is said that Kerala was the first state where the government of CPI, Communist Party of India, was framed all over the world. So it was the first place all over the world where the government of Communist Party of India was made. But when we study the elections, then we come to know that in the first three general elections, Congress won almost 75% of seats. But the voting share of Congress was less than 50%. As we see that, for example, Congress obtained 45% of the total votes, but it managed to win 74% of seats. In the first general election in 1952, Congress won 74% of the total seats, but the voting share of Congress in the first general election was only 45%. And the Socialist Party, the second largest party in terms of votes, secured more than 10% of the votes all over the country, but it could not even win 3% of the total seats. So one more ironical performance there, what is that? The Socialist Party, which obtained more than 10% of the total votes, but it could not win even 3% of seats in the first general elections. How did this happen? For this you need to recall the discussion about the first past the post method in your textbook, Indian Constitution at Work. How this happened, how these differences were created, for this you have to study the first past the post. And this method was discussed in the previous book, in the previous class, Indian Constitution at Work. In the system, the parties which get minimum votes, their voting share is divided into the parties which get maximum shares and is added in their in the counting of the parties which obtains maximum votes. So at present this method is also applied for the elections of the president of India. But when we talk about the non-Congress votes were divided between different rivals, parties and candidates. There is one more thing, that Congress party was united and all the citizens who supported Congress, they voted for the Congress, and on the other hand, non-Congress voters were divided into several parties. That's why those parties could not manage to win maximum seats as compared to the share of their votes. So there are some cuttings from the newspapers, and in these cuttings we see that, and this is communist victory in Kerala. This is the cutting of the Hindu, and that is of 1957, when in Kerala Congress lost the elections and CPI government was framed in Kerala. So dear students, there was one more thing, that when the Congress could not manage to make its government in Kerala, but the Congress government was framed at the center, as it was the only ruling party all over the country, the most dominating party. So it applied Article 356 in Kerala, and declared the government of Kerala unconstitutional and applied their emergency. So Congress started playing dirty politics in the state of Kerala. So in this note we studied that in the first three general elections there was only a dominating party, that was Congress, and it scored more than 70% of votes, total seats, and around 45% of total share of votes. So I think you got this point very well, and if you have any doubt, you can ask your doubt through the comment box. And at last, thank you for watching this video.